스프린터.
2 eldest brothers and he had very ambitious sister Sofia. When his father Alexei died, Peter the Great was very young. He was only 5 years old. And our next Tsar became his eldest brother Theodore, or Fyodor in Russia. He was our Tsar only 3 years. By the gossips, he was poisoned by his sister Sofia, who wanted to be on the throne of Russia. But by Russian rules, by rules of Russian Tsarstva, sister.
What? Can a woman be a ruler?
No,
not in Russia.
But how does she want to be a ruler?
But she found a way. She was very smart. She became a regent of 2 youngest brothers. Until nowadays, in Moscow, in the armory, it's like treasure gallery of Russian Tsars, you may find a silver throne with 2 seats. 1 seat for Ivan, for elder brother of Peter the Great, the second seat for Peter the Great. And on the back of Peter the Great seat, there would be a small window. During meetings, Sofia was standing behind of Peter the Great, and in a small window, she was telling him what he should answer on different questions.
What do you mean? So she teach him what to say?
Yeah.
She's hiding behind
him. His elder brother, Ivan, he was older than Peter the Great. He was about 16 years old. But he was a legal friend. He was stupid. He was silly. He could not make his decision because too stupid. And Sofia was very regent, and she liked it. But she understood when Peter the Great became 18 years old, she should return power to him. Because on the throne of Russia, there should be only men. And she did not like it, and she decided to kill Peter the Great in order to be a regent of stupid brother till his death. His mother of Peter the Great, when she understood such situation, she decided to save her son. She took him away from Moscow, from Kremlin, and he was living with her in her small mansion, in her small palace, not far from Moscow, in Pereyaslavl town. And she understood it would be very difficult for him to fight against Sofia because she had a lot of relatives. She was a very powerful person. And she decided to give him a good education. Almost all teachers of Peter the Great, they were European teachers from Great Britain, from Germany, from Prussia, from Spain. That's why he was growing up more European than Russian. And also, Peter the Great was asked to marry on his first wife. His first wife was very powerful person. Her parents were very, very powerful in Russia. And with the help of her relatives, Peter the Great became our Tsar. Because when Sofia was trying to kill him the third time, the Lopukhini, the family of his wife, said no. On the throne of Russia, there should be only men. But Peter the Great had never been good person. He was very good emperor, but never been good person. When he became our emperor, our Tsar, the first thing which was done by him, he divorced with his wife.
Oh, divorce.
Yeah, because he was too stupid. She was too stupid for him. Okay. He was like European person. She was Russian once. Okay. It was like she could not think like he. And that's why he decided to divorce with her. And what does it mean to be divorced at that time?
No.
To be sent to a nunnery. We didn't have a prison. We had nunneries for Russian tsarinas. And that's why in a few years, his first wife, Евдокия Лопухина, died in this nunnery. Because by the rules of Russian tsarstva, the wife of Tsar would never be married anymore.
Okay.
She should be a widow, or she should be living at nunnery. He said, you would be on the throne if I would be your regent. You would be like a face of the Romanovs, the face of the family. I would be standing behind her throne like the mind of the Romanovs. He wanted to be her regent. She was asked to sign special document that she was agree with such situation. This document was signed, but after coronation, Alexander Menshikov was invited to her palace. There was bourgeois revolution. The owners of banks, insurance companies, different kind of offices, they were against him. And he was forced to sign abdication. He became the ordinary noble person. And in 1917, we received the new revolution, Bolshevik revolution, where the leader was Lenin. Lenin didn't want to kill Nicholas II. He wanted to save his life, and he sent him from St. Petersburg to Yekaterinburg and wrote the letter to British Queen Victoria, where he asked to invite her granddaughter, the wife of Nicholas II, was granddaughter.